welcome back. If I'm looking a little bit different today, it's because I've got a full face of new makeup on. And this is a review of three really big brands that have launched in the UK that are totally new. There is Jones Road Beauty, the new launch from Bobbi Brown. There is Monica Blunder Beauty, which is from makeup artist Monica Blunder. And there's Rose Ink from Rosie Huntington Whitely. And the only reason it's taken me a while to get around to doing this is because I was waiting for enough products to come in for me to give you a proper review. And there still aren't that many Rose Ink products around. So where do we start? Let's start with Jones Road Beauty. Now, I've been a huge fan of Bobbi Brown for as long as I can remember. I'm very much a Bobbi Brown MAC type of person. I just love their products. I love the classic colors. I love the fact that they're pretty idiot proof to apply, and I am the idiot. So I'm expecting a lot from Jones Road Beauty, and I'm gonna start by saying the idea behind it is very, very central to the core, original core of what Bobbi Brown was. I've interviewed her so many times over the last 20 years. She wanted a foolproof what I use in my kit collection of makeup that we could all use and apply easily with minimal amount of tools and skill. So the idea behind Jones Road Beauty is that she's creating something that doesn't exist. Well, they do exist, but this is a very interesting take on a minimum amount of products, but they're launching more products the whole time. Now, the problem I have with Jones Road Beauty is the clean thing. I've looked on the site and nowhere can I see what clean means. Obviously, I don't believe in the concept of clean beauty. There's no such thing as dirty beauty. Clean is meaningless when it comes to beauty. It's unregulated, it means nothing. It's scaremongering, don't fall for it. Bobbi, be better than the Gap. Bobbi Brown, be better than the Gap. You're better than clean beauty. You don't need to go that way. They can simply be functional, utilitarian, take you back to basics, blend it with your own fingers, minimum effort, maximum results makeup, and we would buy into you because we will buy whatever you're selling, Bobbi Brown. We will. You don't need to scaremonger with clean. Now, where do I start? I'm going to start by saying I really love her face crayons. Now, Bobbi Brown is the creator of the original foundation stick. This is her modern equivalent, and it's more like a concealer stick, but it is designed to be used all over. Now, Bobbi was always about minimum effort, maximum results. So it makes sense to me that she would do a series of sticks. I really like this. This is sort of similar, but very slightly harder to blend and gives more coverage than my beloved Arboreum CC stick. So this is her face stick and it comes in 25 shades and it's £23. £23 is about right for a concealer that size. I think unless you've got a lot of moisturizer or you've got an oily skin, that's going to be really hard to blend out into a foundation. It just is. But for me, I've got it on as a concealer. I really like it. Blended in brilliantly. I really like the finish. By the way, if you're asking what I've got on the rest of my face, it's the Monica Blunder cover, but I'll get onto that in a minute. So I'm going to start by saying I love those. Tonight, I'm going to do a live with Ruby Hammer. Ruby Hammer also loves these. Now, what's interesting about them is she found the shades that suited her, and she said she finds it really difficult to find these concealer sticks in shades that suit her. So she is Anglo-Indian. So I think that's really interesting. I'd be very interested if anybody's out there who's got a darker shade of skin to Ruby and what you think of them. But I really like this. This is going straight into my kit. What else is in the range? Well, I've got the mascara on. There's nothing special about the mascara, but then I'll be really honest with you, I've never been a big fan of Bobbi Brown mascaras anyway. If you're gonna launch a mascara, do something a bit more interesting than that. You know, do something like Charlotte Tilbury Pillow Talk Push-Up Lashes, which is the cone technology. It's fine, it's a nice mascara, there's just nothing special about it. Bobby's never going to speak to me again if she ever watches this. Where do we go next? The eyeshadows are great. Bobbi does great eyeshadows. She gets it. She gets the concept of the really cool packaging. She gets how to blend and add pigment. She just gets eyeshadows. These are the best eyeshadows. They're £23 and they come in 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14 shades. 14 shades. And they come in a range of finishes, sparkles, matte. They're just really nice. I actually really love the packaging. I love that slightly utilitarian, totally different look. You know, if you look at the way the brushes are packaged, look, they come like this. what do the brushes look like? They look like this. You know, Bobbi knows how to do these staples. She really does. That's what she's really good at. She knows all the best makeup factories. She knows where to go to source the best eyeliner pencils. She would have gone straight to the same factories, I presume, that she worked with for years at the Estee Lauder Group and just asked them to repackage. That's what I don't get about the idea of clean. What is she taking out of her original Bobbi Brown brand that makes this clean? What's missing from this? What are the toxins? What are the nasties? What are the chemicals that she's taken out of her existing brand that, let's be honest here, she made millions from, that makes this clean? Answers on a postcard, please. However, I have to say, I love the eyeshadows, and there's even one that's a dupe of my beloved Black Plum that I shall be ordering. I don't have it here. I have more of the neutral shades. It's called Dark Brown, and it's really nice. I've also loved the best pencil, which is here, which is what I've got on. That's her eyeliner pencil. She would have known where in Germany to source these. It's quite hard, but that's quite good for people if you have transfer onto the lower lid. I've got it in my tight liner and in the base of my lashes. It's the perfect shade. It's a gorgeous neutral, very slightly shimmery brown. Love, 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 love. That is £20. So we're coming in at sort of MAC Bobbi Brown prices. I don't understand why anybody ever would launch a lip gloss that looks like this. I'm just so over this packaging. I want something with an inbuilt wand. So there are only glosses at the moment. There aren't actually lipsticks. And then we're going to finish with, well, actually, yeah, no. There are also these Just a Second eyeshadows, which are these, that's that MAC technology. You know, you push and then they bounce back up again. It's like a cushion technology, but there's not a huge amount of pigment payoff on this, and it is a tiny little pot, but I do quite like that sort of cream to powder soft shimmer eyeshadow. I do. It's a nice product. Personally, that's not enough pigment payoff for me for that sort of product. I would rather stick with the original eyeshadows, but if you love a cream to powder finish, then that makes sense. That to me looks absolutely identical to all of the MAC products that you've got that you push. You know, the ones that you push and then they come back up again. And they look like they're giving a good pigment payoff, but when you transfer them across, it's pretty subtle and soft. But I guess maybe that's what she's trying to do. Maybe she's trying to do a soft, typical Bobbi look. And then I'm gonna finish with, before I finish the whole of Jones Road, because again, I like what she does. I like Bobbi. I want to like these. I genuinely do. And the 25 shades of face sticks are amazing. They really are. I'd be really interested if more of you can use them for darker skin tones. I also love everything about the packaging. I'm presuming at this point that they are going to be refillable, Bobbi, because if you're going to be clean, you should be clean to the planet. And I presume that also this plastic packaging is recyclable, reusable. Questions on a postcard. You see, if you come for clean, some non-clean believer is going to bite your backside back. They really are. And then I'm going to finish with the Miracle Balm, which comes in a range of shades. It's £34. Not for me. I don't like high shimmer glossy finishes. I opened it up expecting it to have the same texture as the Chanel Bronze Universel, but it's not. It's sticky and gunky and your hair gets stuck on your face. It's a little bit like having a lip gloss on your face. Now, if you're young and you've got gorgeous skin and you love a high shine finish, go for it. Smells quite heavily of linalool, which I wouldn't use on sensitive skin. But that's not for me. That's just not my texture. Not. Now, Bobbi, I know, has chronically dry skin. So she tends to formulate for a sort of drier skin. She likes a lot of humectants, a lot of actives in her product. She always has. It's why her original foundation sticks were so popular, because they blended absolutely brilliantly on dry skin. Because in the back of her mind, she was like, I'm going to create this for me. If you've got a drier skin, you might like that formulation. But for me, I just don't like anything sticky on my face at all. I have powdered this all down with Beauty Pie One Powder Wonder. So, good and bad. Interesting. I want to support her. We need to stop the whole clean thing. It's madness. I really love the packaging. Love the packaging. Why isn't it refillable? Right, moving on. Monica Blunder. Monica Blunder is an absolutely charming and very talented Austrian makeup artist. She's based in America though, and she has launched Blunder Cover. Let me show it to you. Now, this is really interesting. This is essentially Bobbi Brown stick, but in a pot. It's just a single product. It's £45 and it's a single pot of foundation concealer. It comes in 14 shades. It's £45 and there is a brush as well. So not enough shades. That's going to be my first question. I've got 4 shades here and I'm wearing it and I have to say I really like it. It's great. Now, here's my problem. You are only going to be able to blend it on damp, skincare damp skin because it's thick. It's, you know, it's like, it's a proper balm foundation. It's like a stick foundation. And the other thing is that the brush that you've got is just, it's not for me. If you're a professional makeup artist, you're gonna love this product. When she launches 42 shades, everybody's gonna have died and gone to heaven. Because I get that you go in and blend out and it takes ages. I don't have time to do any of that, Monica. I get that makeup artists are gonna love this. I get that if you spend a lot of time on your makeup, you're gonna love it. I absolutely love the finish, but I have to say, I have massively powdered it because I don't like the dewy, slightly dewy finish. It's a heavy coverage that blends out on skincare damp skin, but not with that brush. I would apply my eyeshadow with this. I'm lazy. I want it to be super quick. You know, I tried it with this and then I ended up going back in with that and that's how I got this finish. This is the It Cosmetic dual-ended brush. I want my brush to be slightly firmer, that's slightly too soft, and I want it to be able to move the product around quickly. Like 5 minutes and I'm out. I haven't got 5 minutes to do my base. I'm lazy. A minimum effort, maximum results. But in principle, I think this brand could go from strength to strength. Monica, do a blunderbuss idiot-proof brush. Just do a dual-end brush. That side for the concealer, that side for the face, for idiots like me that don't have time to do this. I believe Sam Chapman loves the product and that's who it's aimed at. Somebody who has the time to properly blend their makeup. That's not me. But I really like it. It's available at Cult Beauty. And I do think moving forward, it will be very interesting. I like to powder the finish. Right. Finally, I waited for this brand to come in. And I waited and waited and waited. And I adore Rosie Huntington Whitely. She is such a kind person. In fact, I have to tell you, all three of these women are really nice in my experience. You have not heard a bad word about them. Brand founders, if you're a beauty editor and you've been around as long as I have, you will end up hearing the truth about brand founders. Most of them are narcissistic arseholes, right? You'll never hear a bad word about Bobbi, you'll never hear a bad word about Rosie, you'll never hear a bad word about Monica. They are genuinely lovely, powerful, talented women, and that's why I want to support them. So I waited and waited and waited for the Rosie Huntington Whitely stuff to come in, and I remember being on counter at Space NK the day they all came in and went on store. What's interesting about Rose Inc. is just, it was pointed out to me that, you know, when you look at a piece of on-counter kit and they have the shades, they always go right, they always go left to right, lightest to darkest, which is the way that we read. So we read light to dark, right? We read left to right. That's what we do in the West. Very interestingly, she has flipped it and the shades go from dark to light. Kudos to you, Rosie, for noticing that we don't live in a white-centric world, because the vast majority of people in the world where you're eventually going to sell aren't reading from left to right looking at white shades. I really like that. It was pointed out to me by the really lovely girl in Hans Crescent Space NK. And I just think that's just a really interesting nod. Now let me tell you about the product. So there are 18 shades of concealer and they're £23 each. I don't have the concealer to try, but it is a little wand and it looks quite similar, and I have tested it on counter, to NARS Radiant Creamy Concealer. More importantly, a lot of these products are refillable. Thank you, Rosie Huntington Whitely. So this is refillable and this is the standout product within the range. This is the blush. It comes in 6 shades. It's £23. And this is the one that everybody's been going crazy about, this shade. This is Azalea. And this is what I've got on. And it looks like a sort of slightly shimmery powder, but it's actually a cream that blends out. I know for a fact that Rosie always uses cream blush. She probably applies this with her fingers. It does come with a brush. I don't like the brush at all. It's really spiky. It moves the product. It doesn't blend the product. I'm wearing this blush over the top of the blunder cover that I did powder out first, and it just moved everything around and I had to go back in and reapply it and then powder afterwards. But I don't like a shimmery finish. If you're young and you've got beautiful skin, some of the feeds that I've seen on this blusher have been amazing on like gorgeous, juicy 20-year-old skin. That is genuinely, it suits all skin colours, shade. I absolutely love this packaging. I mean, it's beautifully thought through and it's refillable. Rosie. You're lovely. But I have to say that there are products in the range that I'm not that keen on. Now, nowhere in this am I looking at the skincare within these ranges. There is skincare within Bobbi Brown. You know my argument. Why would you buy skincare from a makeup brand? And I've never particularly liked the Bobbi Brown skincare. I just think it's really nice, hydrating, basic skincare. It'd be a bit like the Charlotte Tilbury. There's no real levels of actives in it. You're not getting a big punch of vitamin C. You're not getting a big punch of retinol. You're just getting a really nice base for applying makeup. That's how makeup artists think about skin. They think about it as prepping the skin for makeup, which means it's nice and it's hydrating, but it's nothing special. So if you're looking for a moisturizer, go for it. Rosie has a toner because she suffers from problematic skin, even though you'd never believe it to look at her. But I do know for a fact that she's a huge fan of Shani Darnden. So that's where she's getting her actives from. Right, let's go back to Rosie. The other product I've got is the clear brow gel. Now, it's $19.50 and it does come tinted, but I've been sent the plain clear one, which means it's no good for me. And I have to say also, interestingly enough, Rosie has really obviously beautiful big eyebrows, but this spoolie is far too big for me. That's the spoolie I like. That's the Charlotte Tilbury legendary brows. And I'll be really sarky right here now. Let's be honest here, the original Rosie range for Marks and Spencer's was a ripoff of Charlotte Tilbury. That's the product I would have ripped off from Charlotte Tilbury. That and the mascara, by the way, the Pillow Talk push-up lashes. So what I've seen so far, and I haven't seen a lot of it, I like what Rose Inc is trying to do. I really like the blushes. I love the fact that she's trying to go refillable. I'd love to try the concealer. From what I've tested on counter, it seems like NARS Radiant Creamy Concealer. I just like what she's trying to do in terms of its aesthetic. I like the fact that it's in a broader range of shades, which for a small brand is a big gamble. Good on you for doing it. I'm looking forward to more. That's what I'm going to say, because I know what she will do next. She really likes that sort of Hollywood Flawless Filter Radiant Box, that sort of all-over glowy primer. And in conclusion, may I just say all the power to all three amazing female beauty brand founders. It takes a lot of money and a lot of courage to launch an entirely new makeup brand. And I think all three of them have done a great job. I mean, I'm nitpicking about brushes. I'm being silly. You can use whatever brush you want to apply Monica Blunder. I know that clean is a marketing term. I hope that Bobbi kind of steps away from it and just focuses on what she's really great at, which is colour selection, textures, minimum effort, maximum results, beauty, which is what I stand for too. I adore her. And Rosie, I just, all the love and luck in the world. I hope you go from strength to strength. I hope all of you launch more foundation shades. And I hope, Rosie, that you end up going into foundations too, because I'm sure you will. I know that you see the world and you want to go for it. And good on you. I love these three women. They're amazing. That's my take on absolutely the best new products within three great, new, interesting, one to watch makeup brands. Thank you for watching. Thank you for subscribing. I'll put all the details of all the products down below. What do you want me to do next? How about what to do when your skin has a breakdown coming next weekend? Only because my skin has been breaking down recently, and I'll tell you what I've been putting on it.